Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this very exciting day. Before we begin our program in earnest, we're going to start, of course, with a prayer from one of the many people of faith in this city who believed in the vision of this museum and championed its cause for the last several years, my friend Pastor John Fazen from the Watson Grove Baptist Church. Pastor Fazen.
Shall we bow? God, thank you for this wonderful day. While this moment appears to be a simple ceremony to some, it is much more than that. It is the culmination of a collective investment of blood, sweat, and tears. It is a monument of dedication to a vision that could be reinforced by the compulsion that it should be. It is a cultural repository for the influence of African-American music. It's a jewel of corporate and community collaboration in Nashville and beyond. And it is an open door to views of what is possible for subsequent generations. God, it's not lost on us that this visionary moment happens on the day when we celebrate a visionary, Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. We believe this museum is and will be a special place, and for that we are grateful. We're also grateful for the story that the museum tells. The journey of this country and this world cannot be told without the soundtrack of African-American music. It is deeply entrenched in the roots of our experience. In its rivers of rhythm, the African-American music has helped guide us through the passageways of history, encouraging us to wade in the waters of trials and triumph. When crossroads were presented, African-American music helped to show us the way. Now, as we go forward, may it guide us to a love supreme, one greater than we ever imagined. Even as we navigate difficult days, use this music to unite us as one nation under a groove until we get the message that we are better together. So God, we thank you. Thank you for the gift of the National Museum of African American Music. Thank you for its leadership, board, staff, partners, contributors, and members. Thank you for the competency and the creativity of every hand that helped imagine and build this beautiful space. Thank you for the people of Music City who have opened their hearts to the telling of this story. We also thank you for the elders who became ancestors during this journey. While they are no longer with us in person, we believe they now sit in a great cloud of witnesses cheering us on. God, we ask that you bless this place. We submit it to you and ask that you make it inspiring and transformative to all who experience it. Allow it to grow and flourish beyond even our wildest dreams. We pray in the words of Psalm 90, let the favor of the Lord our God be upon us and prosper for us the work of our hands. We pray this in your name. Amen.
Good morning. This is a special day. Thank you, Pastor Fazen, for those words. I'm honored to join on behalf of Nashville's City Council to be here today. And I'm sorry that our Mayor John Cooper is unable to attend. However, stay tuned for a special message later. NMAAM will be an important institution for this city. We now have a place where young black children can see people who look like them, venerated and celebrated as the icons they are. This museum is a beacon of hope for so many black Nashvillians who now have a place that confirms for all the world to see that this is not someone else's Music City. This is our Music City. Only a few blocks away, Jimi Hendrix cut his teeth, playing in clubs in places like the Club Del Morocco, the New Era Club, Maceo's, and the Club Baron. Otis Redding, Ray Charles, and Little Richard were playing regularly to sold-out crowds every weekend on Jefferson Street. But much like those clubs on Jefferson Street, we've forgotten parts of Nashville's music legacies. NMAAM can help restore some of that lost legacy. Black music has always, always been America's music. NMAAM will show the world just how true that is. Thank you again, and I'd now like to turn the microphone over to my esteemed colleague, Councilman Freddie O'Connell, who's the councilman of this district for which the museum resides. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilmember Hurt, and thank you especially for your leadership that helped deliver this moment today. I'm honored to be here to represent the 19th District where NMAAM is located. As you know, our community experienced a traumatic event when a bomb exploded just a few blocks away early on Christmas morning. That was devastating, and we still have work to do to recover from it. That wasn't the first time that this district, this community, has been rocked by a life-altering event. Just one block from here sits the Woolworth's lunch counter, where the sit-ins took place 60 years ago, and the civil rights movement truly began. One thing that kept us moving then and now is songs of hope and inspiration. NMAAM, which we're calling this, but let's stop. And remember, this is a national museum of African American music, is a physical representation of perseverance. What this museum brings is a constant reminder of resilience and knowing that we can get through hard things. I am proud to be an inaugural member of this museum, and membership is a wonderful way to support it. Black music has always reflected the landscape of here and now. It has had the ability to transform trying moments and provide light in the darkness. I'm excited for everyone to experience this museum firsthand. I know that those who visit will be moved by the amazing history and its highlights of the contributions of many Nashvillians and thousands of other black artists from every corner of the country. With that, I'd like to welcome someone who has been a true supporter of NMAAM, the leader of our state, the Honorable Governor Bill Lee. Governor.
Thank you very much. I'm very honored to be here today to celebrate the National Museum of African American Music. What an important moment this is, not only for Music City, as this is a part of a completion of making this Music City, but it's important to our state, and I believe it's important to our nation. People from across the country and certainly across the world will come here to recognize the role, the important role that African American music has played in the history of our nation, and certainly in the history of Tennessee, We have a rich tradition and a rich legacy of music history in Tennessee, and certainly African-American music has been a significant part of that, from the Fisk Jubilee Singers to Aretha Franklin to the multiple artists on Beale Street. Our music has been steeped in African-American music throughout its history. So it's fitting that this National Museum is located right here in Music City and right here in the state of Tennessee. It's also fitting, I believe, that we cut the ribbon and celebrate the opening on Martin Luther King Day. Martin Luther King, a remarkable leader for our nation, a man to whom music was important in his own life. Gospel music, in particular, played a strong role, as we know, in his faith, which played a strong role in his leadership in this country. So as we celebrate this opening on this special day, it's certainly a powerful reminder of the lives and the legacy of those who have created this country where we live today, a country that we pray is becoming every day a more perfect union. I am proud that the state had a small role in this, but more proud of the larger role that so many had in making sure that this happened in this city and in this state. Thanks for allowing me to be a part of this today. I think I'm going to turn the podium over to the CEO, Henry Hicks.
Good afternoon. What an exciting day. And thank you, Governor Lee, and all of you for being here both physically and virtually. It gives me immense pleasure to say that the National Museum of African American Music is finally complete and ready to open to the public. You know, in mid-June of 2009, when I first met Butch Spiridon and he asked me about getting involved with the plans to build an African-American museum, I never imagined that I'd be standing here today. My involvement in the completion of the museum, I am certain, Pastor Faison, is a miracle. This is a radical, disruptive approach to social justice that refused to die, and which ever so slowly blossomed into this divinely guided miracle of human vision, tenacity, and intellect. We have emerged in a location that to some seems out of place. It's a museum that celebrates African American excellence and culture in the heart of downtown Nashville, and for some that seems odd. The National Museum of African American Music does, in fact, tell a story never before told until now. Today, but I think that we are a perfect fit. The American music that is the soundtrack of our lives is an African innovation, and a scan of American history tells us that the soundtrack of America, as the saying goes, Governor, is made in Tennessee. That includes Memphis, Johnson City, and especially Music City. So NMAAM fills what I call a warm void, joining the Ryman Auditorium, the Country Music Hall of Fame, the Musicians Hall of Fame, and the Schermerhorn Symphony Center to put an exclamation point on our city's brand. On this 35th celebration of the Martin Luther King Jr. holiday, I am reminded that Dr. King shared in his famous dream that there would be a defining moment in our nation's life when we would let freedom ring. And in the culmination of that dream, the sign that we had fulfilled the promises set forth by our founders was when all God's children would join hands and sing an old Negro spiritual, no less. The people, music, and stories that are captured and celebrated in this museum share of hope and genius. The galleries connect Tennessee and American history to artists who are often overlooked or nullified in their own country. The exhibits illuminate black men and women who helped define the sound of America and then shared it with the world, shared it with all of us. I'm also reminded today that Dr. King admonished us that we must learn to live together as brothers, or we'll surely perish together as fools. NMAAM is the personification of one nation under a groove. This is a place for everyone, where we want people from all walks of life to come to learn and play, and where we can celebrate our common humanity. But to achieve that brotherhood, everyone has to be included. And NMAAM takes a big step in that direction. But I think it's important that I point out that I take special pride in this place, in part because NMAAM has been conceived, governed, researched, managed, designed, built, branded, and curated by talented artists and skilled professionals, most of whom happen to be African American. Unfortunately, in 2021, these people are too infrequently given such opportunities. And so today, I thank this all-star team for their dedication and their hard work. I encourage the young people who are watching to take note of what is possible for them to achieve, and I encourage employers to challenge systemic assumptions and hire these experts and the many who are similarly skilled to help you achieve miracles within your business or project. To be clear, NMAAM also epitomizes Dr. King's idea of joining hands to sing. All God's children came together to reach this day, beginning with the citizens of Davidson County in the state of Tennessee, Mayors Purcell, Dean, Barry, Briley, and Cooper, along with the members of the Metro Council Minority Caucus, and Governors Bredesen, Haslam, and Lee provided financial support when no one else would. Butch Spiridon, Connie Kennard, and Harvey Hoskins wouldn't quit when they should have. Paula Roberts kept the torch lit when most thought it had been doused. Kevin Lavender has the distinction of being convinced not to be board chair once, but to be board chair twice. The museum staff kept faith, supporting one another in tough times and finding a way to get it done while working with a boss who was too often figuring it out as he went along. The pioneering members of the Barron Society took a bet that a building that they could not see would one day be built, thereby demonstrating that African Americans would invest in this museum. Dean Oliver, Adrian Foley, Pat Emery, and the team at Brookfield bought into the vision of a startup museum as an anchor to their mixed-use development. And we simply would not be standing here if Ben Rector hadn't exceeded every commitment that he made to me and to this project. Ben and his wife Joan willed NMAAM into existence. Nashville, Tennessee, and the nation are forever in their debt, and I am in awe of him and his visionary dedication. And then, of course, there's my family. I tore my boys away from their home and their friends to come to this strange place called Tennessee. It was an adjustment for them. And I want them both to know that I recognize their sacrifice. I hope today that they're proud and they know that they personally share in this accomplishment. And then my bride of 30 years, Crystal, is sitting over there, and she agreed to take a detour in our life plan for 2 years, 8 years ago. She sold her dream home and left friends and family to be in Nashville to help get this done. Though she's come to enjoy it, she wasn't always happy living here. Dean Oliver with Brookfield asked me several times why I was pushing so hard to meet a target date for completing the museum. I'd tell him something about the need to generate revenue to pay the staff, which was true. But the real reason was that I did not want to go home to tell Crystal about yet another slip in the schedule. after those tough conversations and at the end of some rough days, the ones that were especially exhausting or exasperating, she'd let me tell my tale, pour herself a glass of wine, look at me with a side eye, and usually go to bed early. But the next morning, she'd wake me up early and tell me not to let him beat me. She never quit, so I couldn't either. So thank you, Crystal, for being the secret weapon to getting NMAAM complete. And then finally, to the left and the right of the Rivers of Rhythm are the names of Francis Guest over the theater, and thank you, Charles Starks, and T.B. Boyd, just obscured by the backdrop here. Dr. Boyd was unable to be here today, and I bet that Francis has a Jack and Ginger in his hand as he looks down on us from glory. This was their vision, and we've been privileged to finish what they started. So I hope they're both proud. All right, so our mission is to educate the world, preserve the legacy, and celebrate the central role that African Americans play in creating the American soundtrack. That we are cutting the ribbon on this museum on Martin Luther King's holiday inspires me, and I hope it does you too, to live out that mission. It is also fitting that NMAAM opens its doors in the middle of a pandemic. No challenge is too great. We've been forced to improvise today, but we shall overcome. Portions of the remainder of our event are live and others are pre-recorded. So let's get on with it. For those of you watching from home, following the ribbon cutting, there will be a short video program which includes a virtual tour of the museum, along with messages from key supporters, including Mayor John Cooper, and performances by Kane Brown and Willie Jones. And now please let me introduce you to our board chair, Kevin Lavender, Executive Vice President and Head of Commercial Banking with Fifth Third Bank. Kevin?
Thank you, Henry. Moving words indeed. You know, if I could sing, one phrase comes to mind. If I could sing, I would belt it out. But since I can't sing, I'll just say the phrase, it's been a long time coming. It's been a long time coming. And because it's been such a long time coming, I want to tell you a couple of things that we had to survive to get here. The dot-com bust, the Great Recession, every major not-for-profit in this city raising money at the same time, and held most recently COVID over the last 12, 15 months. But you know what? We didn't build this building in haste, and because we didn't, it's going to stand for generations. And we'll be able to tell the story for everyone about the role that African Americans played and continue to play in music, period. In music, period, we'll tell the world. And the city now has definitely solidified itself as Music City. You know, our work's not done yet. I'd be remiss, I'm a banker. Our work's not done yet, so we still have an endowment to build, we still have programs to run, and we still have to pay off the small amount of debt that we have. So there have been so many people thanked today that I don't have to go down a list and miss out on anybody. But again, as the banker, thank you all for your support, and we'll be coming back to you. So Henry, let's have some fun, and let's cut the ribbon if we can now, please.
All right, so we've got a shot list here that I'm told to follow, and so I'm going to ask Governor Lee if he'd come back up along with Kevin. Sanjel, let me give you this. Yeah, I need just leave. Okay, you can take it.
Yep. All righty. And so we've got Charles Starks, Butch Spryden, and Ralph Scholes, along with Henry and the governor.
Remember not to snip, guys.
Yeah.
All righty.
But I want to keep the snip.
And so our next shot is going to be with Councilwoman Hurt, Kevin Lavender, Henry, and Governor Lee.
Yep, you guys can step on. You guys can actually walk this way.
Yep, and
right?
I can take scissors from you. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, darling.
So when do I get those back?
Oh, that is the question.
Yeah.
All righty, our next shot is going to be Councilman O'Connell, Kevin Lavender, Henry, and Governor Lee. Alrighty, and so our next shot is just going to be of Henry and Governor Lee. Thank you, darling.
Thank you.
Oh, yep, and so you're going to stay here because you're going to be the last shot that cuts the actual word.
Okay.
Alrighty, guys, and so for the final ribbon cutting, we're going to have Henry, Governor Lee, and Kevin Lavender. No, he's got them. Alrighty, everyone, this concludes the live section of the program.
Okay, so I'm supposed to say thank you all again for tuning in today. And of course, we wish we could have done this in person, but for everyone's safety, we're glad to be able to do this virtual event in its place. And on that note, we will be on a limited schedule and capacity for the first few weeks of opening. But please go online and make your reservations and buy tickets at blackmusicmuseum.com. It's the best way to do that. And now for our viewers at home, please also enjoy a performance by RCA Sony recording artist Kane Brown. Messages from our donors and partners who helped us to get where we are today. And then a closing performance by Willie Jones performing his premiere song, American Dream. Thank you all so much for being here.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, no, I won't be afraid. I won't be afraid just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand here, stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me, oh, stand by me, oh, stand now, stand by me, stand by me.
Hello, I'm John Cooper, Mayor of Nashville and Davidson County. It's my pleasure to join you virtually for the grand opening of the National Museum of African American Music. Nashville is known as Music City because of the Fisk Jubilee Singers, who originally formed back in 1871 and broke racial barriers while performing around the world. For generations, Nashville has helped create America's soundtrack. We're a community that celebrates music every day, and African American music is a vital part of that artistic heritage. And this museum provides a one-of-a-kind experience to carry on the important legacy of African American music. Again, congratulations on the grand opening of the museum, and welcome to Music City. Thank you, and stay safe.
This is Ben Rector. The ribbon cutting represents years of dedicated work by many persons in the public and private sectors of this community. Under the leadership of Henry Hicks, Kevin Lavender, and the board, John Fleming and other professionals have designed and built a magnificent National Museum of African American Music. As a community, we celebrate this achievement and hope to share with its visitors the story of the influence African Americans have had on music through the world. Thank you.
Hi, Charles Starks with the Music City Center. On behalf of the Music City Center Board of Directors and team members, congratulations on the opening of the National Museum of African American Music. The Music City Center is proud to have played a role in making this day become a reality. Our board made a financial commitment in honor of former board member Francis Guest. Francis was involved as a volunteer with the museum from the beginning and had a passion for seeing this day become a reality. He worked tirelessly for many years about the significance of the museum with everyone he met. He was then instrumental in working on the original location for the museum at Jefferson and 8th Avenue. However, once the Music City Center was announced, he had the vision there would be no better location than on the site of the old Nashville Convention Center. With the location right in the heart of the entertainment and cultural district of the city, it will become a place that not only educates and entertains Nashvillians, but people from all over the world. Quickly, this will become a place you have to visit while in Music City. What a fitting day for a celebration as our nation honors Dr. King. We open the National Museum of African American Music to the world. I only wish Francis was here to celebrate. Congratulations to Henry, his team, and everyone in the community who has made this dream a reality. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mark Ezell, Commissioner of the Department of Tennessee Tourist Development. And we just are so excited and want to give a special thanks to the team at the National Museum of African American Music and Henry Beecher Hicks. Know how hard he and the team has worked, and we are so appreciative of all that you have done to get ready for today. You know, there are seven genres of music in Tennessee that call Tennessee home, whether it's blues or bluegrass, country, gospel, soul, rockabilly, and rock and roll. There's nothing quite like music to bring people together, and there's going to be no place in the world that celebrates the principles embedded in the history of African American music like this museum. So we're excited that this world-class destination is now opening its doors here in the heart of downtown Nashville. And our tourism team is really proud to get to inspire visitors literally worldwide to experience and the profound stories and to learn and to celebrate music genres that have been created, influenced, and inspired by African Americans. So congratulations on this tremendous occasion, and we celebrate with you. Congratulations and blessings to you in this effort.
I'm Butch Spiridon, President and CEO of the Nashville Convention and Visitors Corporation. Thank you for including me, inviting me today. I am truly honored to be part of this historic moment in Nashville's history. This is a great day for music everywhere, our hospitality industry, and our city. It's been quite a ride to get here today. For me, over 20 years, starts and stops, twists and turns, doubts, and persistence. I'm glad persistence won. And ironically, it seems only fitting that after everything this museum has been through, that we have arrived at today's grand opening during the most tumultuous year in recent history. Today puts the final validation on Music City's brand. My personal thanks to everyone who contributed in any manner at all. Truly appreciate you. Thanks.
Hi, greetings everyone. This is Tom Miller with Brookfield. We're the developer of Fifth and Broadway. And this is not just an exciting day for our project or Nashville, it's an exciting day for the world. This National Museum of African American Music has been destined for Nashville for decades because of the hard work of so many people. And while so many have supported the museum in ways that were impactful and necessary, I'd like to give a special acknowledgement to Henry Hicks, Dion Lucas, and Danny Hildenbrand, along with a very special staff of people that have made today all possible. We've seen firsthand over the years how much energy and work that you put into making this day possible. With tireless commitment to excellence, today your hard work pays off, and this first of its kind museum is opening in Nashville, Tennessee. Since the first day we began working on Fifth and Broadway more than 5 years ago, the National Museum of African American Music has always been our flagship tenant. We're fortunate to have the museum as a North Star for Fifth and Broadway. It's inspired and guided us to make certain this project is the best it can be, because that's what you deserve. So we're humbled at the opportunity to speak today at this historic moment. We're honored to call you our partners and friends, and we can't wait to toast your success at Fifth and Broadway. Thanks so much and best of luck.
Hi everyone, I'm Sherry Neal, Chief Diversity Officer for HCA Healthcare. We have proudly supported the National Museum of African American Music over the last decade, but are especially thrilled to celebrate this special ribbon cutting experience today. Today's such an amazing day as we reflect on and celebrate the impact African Americans continue to have in shaping our culture, especially through music. And we're so honored to be a partner in helping to tell that story. So thank you, NMAAM, for developing this one-of-a-kind destination, preserving the History of America soundtrack, and for being the premier global destination for music lovers of all generations.
Hello, I'm Tuolumne Austin, Executive Vice President of Philanthropy and Social Impact at Sony Music Group. Sony Music Group is honored to support the National Museum of African American Music and celebrate a community that has always been at the heart of American music. An exciting aspect of this partnership is the new Sony Music Scholars Black Music Certification and Scholarship Program, which is an initiative underwritten by our Global Social Justice Fund. The education program will focus on the history of Black music and business and bring a new generation of creators and change agents into the industry. We're also excited for visitors to explore the new Business Behind the Music exhibit, which shines a spotlight on Black executives, labels, and publishers that have made impactful contributions throughout music history. And we're delighted to help the museum bring this exhibit to life. Black artists and industry leaders have laid the foundation of American music from the early days of blues to the top of the charts today. And Sony Music Group is proud to support the National Museum of African American Music in telling their inspiring stories. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Dave Bozeman, Vice President of Amazon Transportation Services. First of all, I just want to thank you for the great opportunity to participate today. I am just sorry, due to the circumstances, we are not meeting in person. No city in America can lay greater claim to our nation's musical heritage than Nashville. So, it is only fitting that this new cultural gem be located in Music City. This institution will pay homage not only to Nashville's history, but also to the myriad of invaluable contributions African Americans have made to America's soundtrack. We are especially proud that Amazon's partnership will mean more young people and students can access the museum and additional education enrichment. Together, Amazon and the museum will co-develop a curriculum that further brings music to life using Amazon tools and programs like Amazon Music and tablets. The stories showcased in this museum are America's stories, whether documenting the history of spirituals and gospel, the evolution of blues and jazz, or the emergence of hip hop. Music lovers worldwide now have even more reason to visit Music City. Congratulations again on reaching this important milestone. We look forward to watching the museum come to life at long last. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. I'm Ralph Schulz, CEO of the Nashville Area Chamber of Commerce. We are proud to be a sponsor of this historic moment for Nashville and Middle Tennessee. We applaud the persistent efforts to make this day a reality for our community. You know, the heritage on display at the museum is a part of all of us, and we really look forward to experiencing all that the museum will offer us as a community and offer the nation. Again, congratulations.
Objectified. commodified and scrutinized by blue eyes and blue and white lights dancing off your skin as he dances in the wind. Fist raised, black shades, black blood, black love, black blood, black love, black love, black love, black love, black love. White man, could you spare a little change? Cause it's change at the front door. White man, can you do right, man? Proud to be a black man, living in the land of the brave and the free. Yeah, I'm all American, and that American dream ain't easy.
Come a long way,
oh,
still got a long way to go.
When you're living as a black man, it's a different kind of American dream. Your plans of allegiance,
still
look at how they treat us. They turn around and beat us. I guess we are fighting demons.
We've come a long way.
We've come a long way.